Hello, my loves. It's Liz Ann here from High Vibes Life, helping you make the rest of your life the best of your life. And if you haven't already, please subscribe so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. So today, I want to talk to you a little bit about jealousy, what it is, why we experience it, and how we can help ourselves out of it if it's something that's really bothering us right now. Being jealous is a very low vibe, and it is only going to attract low vibe things into your life. So it's really important to recognize when you have jealousy on board and to work through it to overcome it so that you can get into a higher vibe in that situation. When you're very jealous of somebody, you're going to usually be very pretentious around them at best, but usually you're going to treat them with a little bit of rudeness and maybe even contempt. There are many reasons why we get jealous. Sometimes it's because we think somebody has something physically more attractive than we do, or they have succeeded in a way that we wish we could succeed, or they have more friends, or they seem like they have more fun, they go more places, or they have a nicer home. A lot of times, jealousy happens within our own family. We'll have a sibling that does really well, and we may secretly be very jealous of their success. It also can happen a lot when you have close friends. You can find jealousy working in many different ways of, you know, wishing you were looked more like them or had the relationship they had with your partner. At the end of jealousy is the word lousy. And lousy means very poor, bad, and disgusting. Because the reality is, jealousy is a disgusting vibration to hold on to. It doesn't feel good to us. It doesn't feel good to the person that we're jealous over. It does absolutely no good for anybody ever. So why do people get jealous? Usually when you whittle it down, you will find that jealousy has its roots in a core belief down inside of people that they are not good enough and therefore do not deserve what they see the person that they're jealous over has. And when they have this belief, because that belief is down there and because they've never worked through that belief and that belief is still activated in their vibration, they aren't able to obtain these things that they see other people have that they want to reach, because underneath it all, they have a core belief that they're not good enough and that they don't deserve. So just think for a minute of somebody that might be jealous of the woman across the street who has a really nice physique, and you might look across the street at her and you have 50 pounds to lose and you've never been able to lose those 50 pounds, and you see her come out of her house every day and go jogging, and you know why she looks the way she looks, but you just can't seem to get yourself motivated enough to accomplish what you see that she has. So even though you may like her as a person, there's a part of you that resents her and is jealous of her because she's able to do what you have not been able to do. But usually the reason behind your inability to accomplish what this person has accomplished is because you've held yourself back with this core belief deep down inside of you that you're not good enough and that you don't deserve to have what she has. When we have these core beliefs that we usually took on in our formative years, they play a major role in our ability to be successful or to be able to create the type of life that we really want to create. But even more, they cause this internal conflict inside of us, because at our core, we still believe that we aren't good enough. So as an example, with the woman across the street, you would look across the street at her, and what is stirring up is you're not good enough and you're not deserving. She's better than you. You're not enough. Sometimes it's hard to figure out where this message came from, or even if it's there. Sometimes we don't even realize that message is there playing a part or playing a role in our life until we do some work and some journaling and ask some powerful questions and answer them honestly. Then we wheedle it down, and usually at the very base of it all is this little message that says, you're not good enough. Perhaps even now you've come to this video because you're dealing with jealousy and you're wondering, how can I get rid of this? I hate feeling this way. Because like I said, jealousy doesn't feel good at all. It doesn't feel good to the person you're jealous over, and it doesn't feel good inside of you because it is an internal conflict of you're not enough. You're not as good as. You don't deserve the same as. So it's a very icky, lousy feeling to have. So how do we overcome this feeling of jealousy? In Louise Hay's work, one of the things that she would have her clients do from the get-go is to say to themselves on a regular basis in front of the mirror and throughout the day, she said 100 times or more a day, say it over and over and over again, I love and approve of myself. Actually, in the beginning, it was just, I approve of myself. I approve of myself. Just say that to yourself over and over and over again. I approve of myself. This is a powerful mantra, and it is especially effective when you use it as those feelings arise in you, as maybe you're looking across the street at that woman and those feelings of jealousy are hitting again, to say to yourself, I approve of myself. I approve of myself. I am perfect just the way I am. I do not need to be like that girl across the street to approve of myself. I approve of myself. I love and approve of myself. So basically, the way you overcome jealousy is to really dig down deep, get to that core message, and to override it with a message that is actually true, and that is that you are enough and that you do deserve just as much as anybody else. When you say, I am enough and I approve of myself, when you start to believe that, even if you haven't attained what somebody else has attained or obtained that you are jealous over, the jealousy dissipates because you start to feel acceptance for who you are and for your life just as it is. And you start to let go of the need to have what that person has to feel like you are enough. So it is very powerful, even though it sounds so simple. In my video, Are Your Goals Making You Depressed? I talked about how our goal-driven society is causing people to lose touch with themselves. Jealousy, a lot of the times, drives that goal-driven society. People start looking out at everybody else, what they're doing and what they have, thinking, well, they look happier than me. They look like they got more than me, and they look like they're healthier and that they're really living, and I don't feel like that inside. And instead of really staying with their own self and trying to figure out what they need personally to meet their own personal needs, they start creating these outward goals and these outward things that they believe if they reach that they will feel better about themselves and have this life that they see looks better than what they feel they have. When you get to the core of I am not enough, which is so much the core of almost every emotional issue that people have out there. When you're able to truly uproot that core, that I am not enough and I do not deserve, you are uprooting so many other issues in life. So starting right there with that mantra, I am enough and I love and approve of myself, is going to be powerful catalyst to get you over the hump of jealousy and to catapult you toward the life that you truly want to be able to live. So try out that mantra and then leave in the comments how it worked out for you. But if you're still feeling frustrated with it and still feel like you need a little more help over this hump, I would love to hop on a one-time only free 30-minute consultation call with you and discuss how we can help you be able to really implement and believe this new message that you are enough and that you are deserving. Just click the link below in the description. Have a good day.